you all, this is MC Winkle, and today, as per request of one of my friends over on Instagram, I am going to be talking about tropes. Okay, for those of you who don't know, a trope is a recurring theme or motive in literature. That would be something like the evil speech of the villain during the climax, or perhaps the orphaned protagonist in the book. So these are things that just keep repeating themselves over in time in many books, and that authors sometimes use, and some people like them, some people don't. Today I have been asked to give my opinion about 5 tropes, and that is exactly what I'm going to do. Before we get started, just a disclaimer that these are all my opinions. They are highly subjective. This is not an objective video in which I'm going to be telling you how you should write. Just my opinions based completely on personal beliefs and preferences that you absolutely don't have to take into account for your writing. Again, I want to say that tropes are something that I think is pretty cool. Some of them are awesome, some of them are not. Using tropes in your writing makes it by no means worse than any other writing. Of course, it's good to come up with original stuff, but sometimes it's inevitable to fall into this sort of things, and as long as they are applied well, tropes can be awesome. Okay, so the first trope that I have been asked to talk about is enemies to lovers. This is a trope that I really like because I think it's really fun to read. I'm not sure how realistic it is, because at least in my experience, I have never really been annoyed by a guy that I actually love, but I have met people, even people in my family who have experienced this, so I think that, yeah, it's pretty cool, and it must be so fun to write, and it's really fun to read. The second trope is the chosen one. Okay, so in my book Beyond, I kind of fall into that trope because Stella is a teenager, and that's another trope, oh my, who is kind of finds herself like being the key to solving a war between aliens and humans. However, at least in my opinion, I give a new approach to the chosen one that kind of differs from the Harry Potter thing, because it's sci-fi, and second, it's not the chosen one in a fantasy land, the heir to a throne. It's just a girl who doesn't really have anything to do with anything, but she is forced into this conflict and they keep her prisoner, so it's not the kind of idealistic thing that people usually do. Plus, it's between aliens and humans, which I think it's a brand new approach. My own excuses aside, I think the chosen one trope is kind of overused, and unless you are able to give it a new approach, you should kind of avoid it. I really like it, and I think sometimes it's inevitable because your story is not going to follow the guy who has a fruit shop just below your house, but it has to follow the protagonist, who is someone who is so obviously important, and sometimes it's really impossible to fall into the chosen one thing. Just kind of try to avoid cliches regarding this, such as and the protagonist having no parents, or the protagonist being, finding a magical device which makes them the chosen one. Just try to avoid what everyone has done before, and if you give it your own personal touch, it can be kick-ass. The third trope is the bad boy needs therapy. Okay, I get pretty annoyed with this thing. So I get that the bad boy is mysterious and cool and with a leather jacket, and that really turns me on, but really, the fact that they all have a troubled childhood is kind of annoying sometimes, because, you know, not everyone has a troubled childhood, and you don't have to have a troubled childhood to be hot. And I don't really understand how a woman can be attracted to a guy that sometimes treats her like shit. So, and really, needing therapy, you people, sometimes bad things happen to people and they don't become assholes. I don't understand why you should justify this just because the guy wears a very cool jacket and rides a motorcycle. The fourth trope is that everyone important is alive at the end of the war. Okay, so this annoys me so much. I hate it. I mean, I like people to live. I like the characters and I want them to live, but that's not real life. In real wars, in no matter which sides win, the end is sad because you have lost people. And more often than not, it's the innocent people that die and not the ones who just started the whole thing. So yeah, if you have a bunch of characters who go into the battlefield and none of them die, it's just not realistic. And I think actually a death, especially at the end of a series perhaps, that you have the final battle, kind of adds emotion to it, and I am not against deaths in final battles. What's more, I am in favor of them, because I think that's just life. The last trope that I'm going to talk about is the MC getting the hot hottest partner. Okay, so I get it. We all want to feel related to the MC. We all want to be like them. They're mostly pretty. And now they get the hottest boyfriend. Okay, I can kind of buy that. But sometimes you get these main characters who are so insecure and who don't really have any self-confidence, and they think of themselves as a pile of shit. So then, really, why would the hot guy go to them? Because I get that maybe you're super pretty, but if you are just wallowing in self-pity constantly, I don't understand how you could attract anybody, to be honest. Anyway, I just don't think it's realistic that all the hot guys go after the main character, and it happens so often, and it's sometimes annoying. I mean, there are other pretty girls around, or boys, you know, I'm talking about girl main characters because I'm a girl, and I kind of find it easier to talk about it this way, but I don't know why would every single guy be chasing the same girl when you have more girls in your cast, because you do, right? If you don't, you kind of have a problem. Anyway, that's my opinion on this trope and the others. They are totally personal opinions. I hope that you enjoyed hearing what I think. If you did, please give me a thumbs up and be sure to comment with your own opinions, because I would totally love to hear about them. Okay, you guys, this has been everything for today. Thank you so much for watching. This is MC Winkle, self-published author. I have just released my book Beyond, so I encourage you to check it out. And for those of you who don't know, I want to help you become a published author as well. So if you want that, be sure to click that subscribe button to stay tuned to my writing advice. Okay, guys, I'm gonna leave now. Have a great weekend. Bye!